Next, we have our session based on ADAS and autonomous driving. And for that, first of all, I would like to call on stage Mr. R.R. Singh, Head Transport Engineering Department, Bureau of Indian Standards, to present his lead talk. Mr. R.R. Singh.
Respected delegates, a very warm good afternoon to each one of you. First of all, I would like to congratulate NASSCOM Center of Excellence and Telematics Wire for organizing TI 2019. As you all know, the topic for today's concluding session is ADAS, paving way for autonomous driving. Autonomous or self-driving or driverless driving is a technological feat which is possible by using autonomous vehicles which are capable of sensing the environment and moving safely with low or no human inputs. These vehicles combine a variety of sensors to perceive their surroundings, such as radars, lidars, sonars, GPS, odometry, and inertial measurement units. Advanced control system interprets sensory information to identify appropriate navigational paths as well as obstacles and relevant signages. According to SAE, there could be 6 levels of driving automation, starting from level 0, where the automated system issues warnings but has no sustained vehicle control, to level 5, where no human intervention is required at all. The autonomous vehicles generally use modular architecture, wherein the first layer is device layer, the second layer is network layer, the third one is service layer, and the final layer is the content layer. The consequence of layered modular architecture of autonomous vehicles is that it enables the emergence and development of platforms and ecosystems around products and certain modules of the product. Now, autonomous driving will give some benefits, which could be saving in driving time, fuel economy, augmentation of shared mobility, helpful for elderly, disabled, and children, reduction in insurance costs due to increased road safety, etc. However, possible technological and social challenges also appear to be from the facts that AI is still not able to function properly in chaotic inner city environments. Car security could be potentially compromised, wherein the automotive cars could be used by terrorists as bombs. So this is also one of the challenge which the automotive cars have to face in future. And susceptibility of the car's sensing and navigation system to different weather conditions. Requirement of very high quality specialized maps. Competition for radio spectrum. Improvements in road infrastructure. Potential loss of jobs of drivers for various types of vehicles, legal issues related to accident liabilities, programmer's dilemma as to how a vehicle can be programmed to behave in an emergency situation where either passengers or other traffic participants like pedestrians, bicyclists, and other drivers are endangered. But whatever be the level of vehicle driving automation, ADAS will always play an important role in it. ADAS are electronic systems that aid a vehicle driver while driving. When designed with a safe human-machine interface, they are intended to increase vehicle safety and, more generally, road safety. Most road accidents occur due to human error. The automated system, which is provided by ADAS to the vehicle, is proven to reduce fatalities by minimizing human error. ADAS relies on inputs from multiple data sources, including automotive imaging, LIDAR, radar, image processing, computer vision, and in-car networking. Additional inputs are possible from other sources separate from primary vehicle platforms, such as other vehicles, which is known as V2V or vehicle-to-vehicle, or vehicle-to-infrastructure, such as mobile telephony or Wi-Fi data network systems. ADAS are one of the fastest growing segments in the automotive electronics, with steadily increasing rates of adoption of industry-wide quality standards in vehicular safety systems such as ISO 26262, developing technology-specific standards such as IEEE 2020 for image sensor quality and communication protocols such as vehicle information APIs. Now, some example of ADAS which are used or which could be possibly used in future are adaptive cruise control, glare-free high beam, adaptive light control, anti-lock braking, automatic parking, automotive navigation system, automotive night vision, blind spot monitor, collision avoidance system, crosswind stabilization, cruise control, driver drowsiness detection, electric vehicle warning sounds, electronic stability control, emergency driver assistance, forward collision warning, intersection assistance, hill descent control, intelligent speed adaptation, lane centering, lane departure warning system, lane change assistance, parking sensors, pedestrian protection systems, rain sensor, surround view system, tire pressure monitoring system, traction control, traffic sign recognition, turning assistance, vehicular communication system, wrong way driving warning, and the list will go on and on. But effective adaptation and implementation of ADAS will demand a transformational change and a paradigm shift in Indian mobility space, and will call for collaborations cutting across industries to include automotive, telecom, ICT, etc., as well as key departments in the government. Keeping this in view, Niti Aayog has taken initiative to prepare a draft national ITS policy framework, framework of India, wherein advanced vehicle safety system features predominantly in form of longitudinal collision avoidance system, lateral collision avoidance, intersection collision avoidance, vision enhancement for crash avoidance, safety readiness, pre-crash restraint deployment, automated vehicle operation, etc. For effective implementation of these, we shall need an interoperable and repeatable national infrastructure, and standards will play a very important role in it. I'm enlightened that discussions have started taking place at various platforms to make transportation clean, connected, comfortable, safe, and shared. It is for sure that the growth story of India shall be written on the canvas of planned development and scripted with the instrument of intelligent mobility solutions, which will ensure safe and efficient movement of passengers and freight, both in urban and rural areas. I am sure that in the panel discussions to follow, the eminent panelists will have a fruitful discussion for paving the way forward for ADAS in India. Such discussions will definitely enable to shape the country into an integrated, safe, and inclusive community through accessible, affordable, shared, connected, clean, and smart transport system, enabling an effective transport management environment for movement of the people and goods. And now, because I belong to the National Standards Body, BIS, I would like to let you know how the national standardization takes place. In a brief, I'll tell you just how the national standardization what is a standard? The standard is a document established by consensus and approved by a recognized body that provides for common and repeated use, rules, guidelines, and characteristics for activities on their or their results aimed at the achievement of the optimum degree of order in a given context. So this is a standard which has been prescribed in the ISO 2 standard, which is followed by BIS in formulating the standards. Now, The standards are major assets for companies, governments and communities, consumers and citizens. Now the aim of standardization is to provide fitness for purpose, compatibility, interchangeability, variety control, safety, protection of the environment and product protection. This has also been taken from ISO guide 2. Now this is the standardization space in which we generally work. On the x-axis there is level of standardization which starts from individual level and ends at international level. From the subject, the in engineering, industry, commerce, science, education, transport and so on and so forth, there could be various subjects on each level. And on the aspect space, there could be nomenclature, specification, sampling and inspection, test and analysis, limitation of variety, code of practice, model form of contract. So this gives an overview of the standardization space. So the standards could be followed at any level, on any subject, and on any aspect. So there could be various combinations of standardization which can take place. Now, as far as the national standardization is concerned, BIS Act 2016 gives BIS the status of a national standards body, which gives BIS the power to establish, publish, review, and promote the Indian standard in relation to any goods, article, process, system, or service in such manner as may be prescribed. Now, the standard formulation process is this, that the request for the standards can come from government, ministry, consumer organization, user, industry, or industry association, professional bodies, technologists, members of the bureau, members of BIS technical committee. So all these people, they can request to BIS for formulation of any standard. Now the steps in standardization include the subject and its aspect are chosen, the appropriate time frame for standardization is decided, and the entire system stakeholders are covered to obtain feedback, the standards is published, and the publicity and implementation of standard takes place, and thereafter the review and improvement of the standards is also taken care of. Now this is these are the various stages in the formulation of standard. Stage 1, where the new work item proposal is received, then working draft is made, then preliminary draft is made, then wide circulation draft is prepared, which is wide circulated to a vast circulation list. Then the finalized draft is prepared, then Indian standard is published. Now stage 2 to stage 3 is building consensus among panel committee members, and stage 3 to stage 5 is national consensus. So BIS follows a practice of collaborative, collective and consensus based approach for national standardization. Without that, the national standard will have no meaning. So this kind of approach is imperative for formulation of standards by national standard body. Now this is the standard formulation process, the committee structure. Committee members include manufacturers, consumers, technologists, regulators, and other such body who are interested in that technical committee. Then we generally have meetings, consensus approach is adopted, wide circulation of the document is done, then finalization of the document is done, the standard is printed, and periodic review of the standard is done. So this gives, in a nutshell, what all the standardization activities are there, which are followed by BIS in formulating national standards. Till now, we have published 20,092 standards on various product standards, safety, system, test methods, code of practice, terminology, dimension, and others. Now, BIS has taken some recent initiatives. We have signed MOUs with IITs and HBTU for assisting us in formulating the standards. We have also organized various young standardizers program. We have taken training of committee members. We have started funding for R&D projects to augment national standardization. We have done a national standardization action plan. We have prepared that. And more informative and interactive BIS website has been created. And funding for participation in international standardization is also taken care of by BIS. Now, what we expect for industry for national standardization work, as I have told you, that standardization work, national standardization work is the work of all the stakeholders, relevant stakeholders put together. It is not a part of any institution or organization alone. So everybody has to come together and participate in national standardization activity. Only then the standard which will be formulated by BIS, that will be accepted and adopted by one and all. So what we expect from industry is that active participation in national and international committee and panel meetings, timely scrutiny and comment on draft Indian standards under wide circulation, timely scrutiny and comments on ISO drafts, nominating the suitable technical person for standardization work, constitution of parallel mineral committees in line with the national technical committees in specific areas in their own organizations, support any study on or R&D work being undertaken for development of Indian standard, implementation of Indian standard in their respective areas, act in true national perspective during the standard development process, timely completion of assigned work. So now, as far as the ADAS is concerned, we have, BIS has got a dedicated sectional committee, that is TD22, and the top title of that committee is Intelligent Transport System Sectional Committee. The scope of that committee is standardization of information, communication and control systems in the field of urban and rural surface transportation, including autonomous, connected, intermodal and multimodal aspects thereof, traveler information, traffic management, public transport, commercial transport, emergency services, and commercial services in the intelligent transport system, including associated security issues. And this committee also coordinates with ISO TC204 and ISO TC241 for the international standardization work. Now, the standards which have been formulated by this committee, they are electronic various standards on electronic fee collection, LED destination board system for buses, automotive tracking device and integrated system, RFID system for automotive applications, and some of the topics which are under consideration which relates to ADAS are RPAS, that is reverse parking assist system, TPMS, that is tire pressure monitoring system, ABS, anti-lock braking system, ACS, electronic stability control, and LDW. As far as the role of the industry is concerned, industry is the driving force for standardization in any country throughout the world. Strong standardization ecosystem leads to strong economic system. Proactive approach in standardization may lead to global leadership. Strive for building a quality culture in the country through standardization and effective implementation of the national standards. And we can have a single motto of standardize in India. It will take care of all other mottos such as make in India, design in India, and all, and we can take up leadership positions in regional and international standardization. And I would like to end with a quote of C. Rajagopalachari. He said that standardization is to industry what culture is to society. So if a standardization of any country is robust, it means that industry itself is very robust. And if a culture of any society is very strong, it means the society itself is strong. So with this, I request all of you to just join in the national standardization work and come together, not only for ADAS, for any other thing. We have got a very transparent system. You can comment on any standard whenever you like. So with this, I thank you for your attention. I hope this presentation was useful for you and you have got some kind of impetus for joining in national standardization work. Thank you so much.